discuss that who are we, in order to address fundamental question concerning what is good and what is bad, what ought to be and what ought not to be, the initial reference point is that who we are. Secondly, what is the temporal existence of our being? The second issue is that when we decide that who we are, then we have to decide where we are existing. And existing does not mean space, existence means temporality. The second issue we will discuss, that what actual temporal existence of our people who are sitting here. And third, what is the purpose of our existence? And we will try to analyze these three questions, that who we are, secondly, what are our temporal specification, and thirdly, what is the telos, what is the purpose, and how we are going to reconcile these three questions in our existence. Unfortunately, we are living in four centuries at a time. Our religious infrastructure is almost 1400 years of age. Our social infrastructure is like that of 17th-18th century. We are living in this century and we have the information of next century. So we are experiencing a particular kind of temporal stratification. We have been divided in different temporal stages, almost four different centuries. Because of this temporal stratification, we have developed different identity paradigms. And it is difficult for us, and mostly our youth, to reconcile these temporal stratification. Our post-colonial thinkers, since I am student of philosophy and not professional art, so I am more interested in the philosophical dynamics of our existence rather than artistic. But those people who were working in pre-partition India, and in fact after partition as well, they are trapped with a particular kind of consciousness, which I consider as belated consciousness. We are, and the young generation of our people, they are trapped with a consciousness which is belated consciousness. The consciousness of being left behind. हमारे लोगों का ये ख्याल है कि हम पीछे रह गए. You can experience this overwhelming consciousness of being left behind throughout our literature. And in fact, many people, whether they are political theorists, whether they are historians, whether they are artists, and even the religious thinkers, the religious political thinkers, they also believe that we are being left behind. But the question is, from whom? And in what context you are interpreting history? So we are interpreting history in a particular kind of historicism. There are certain people who are far ahead from us and we are here, and some societies and some people are way back from us. The solution they have derived from their historical experience, from their post-colonial historical experience, is that modernism is the solution. We can resolve our problems, we can resolve our cultural, we can resolve our traditional, we can resolve our political, we can resolve our economic problem from a mechanism of modernization. So modernization is one of the consensuous solution prescribed by many of the thinkers. And because of this overwhelming justification of the process of modernization, it has been acknowledged as a state ideology. It has been acknowledged as a civil society parameter. It has been identified as my individual objective to develop a particular kind of self which is consistent and compatible with modern ways of life. We want to develop a particular kind of society which is consistent and compatible with modern ways of life. And we also want to develop a particular kind of state which is consistent and compatible with modern ways of existence. Okay, fine. You want to do that? Go ahead. But the problem is that the intellectual world is not satisfied with this overwhelming mechanism of modernization. Those people whom we are identifying as our ideals at the level of state, at the level of society, at the level of individuality, they are not satisfied with this. These are the people. There are certain people like postmodernist, deconstructionist, post-structuralist. They are ruthlessly criticizing and damaging the intellectual defense provided by the 18th and 19th century modern thinkers. So we are trapped in an intellectual dilemma. We are trapped in a dilemma because we have not been developed yet, but we are in the process of development. But the problem is that those people who are experiencing the modern life world for the last 300 years, they are not satisfied with that. And the major thinkers of contemporary Western world are not satisfied with this overwhelming, mechanical, brittle, iron cage of rationality. Problem kya hai? Problem ye ke we are developing a system which is in the process of modernization, and the intellectual justification provided by the 18th and 19th century post-colonial intellectual has no justification in front of postmodern critique of modernity. Agar aapko kuch indicators hum dikhayen, for instance, Pakistan ke agar compare kar lein, ek एडवांस इंडस्ट्रियल सोसाइटीज है, पाकिस्तान में इस वक्त जेलों में कितने लोग हैं? हाउ मेनी पीपल आर इन कन्फाइनमेंट सेंटर? ऑलमोस्ट कितने लोग होंगे आपके ख्याल में? पाकिस्तान 160 मिलियन पीपल, अमेरिका 170 मिलियन पीपल, कितने लोग होंगे पाकिस्तान की जेलों में? कितने थाउजेंड है? 50,000. और अमेरिकन जेलों में कितने होंगे? 2 लाख. 2 लाख आदमी ज्यादा से ज्यादा कितने हो सकते हैं? 2.5 लाख. 2 मिलियन लोग हैं अमेरिका में जेलों में. 2 मिलियन पाकिस्तान में. ये पुरानी हो गई स्टैटिस्टिक्स. ये जो अभी चीफ जस्टिस है बहुत एक्टिव हैं, उन्होंने काफ़ी इसको एक्सपेडाइट किया है. पाकिस्तान में 88,000 थे, ये वाले चीफ जस्टिस आने से पहले पोजीशन ज़्यादा ख़राब थी, तो उस वक्त जो थे वो कोई 10,000 या 12,000 लोग कन्विक्टेड थे, बाकी अंडर प्रोसेस थे। 88,000 एंड 2 मिलियन, 2 मिलियन मीन्स 20 लाख, 20 लाख आदमी जेलों में बंद है। 84% पीपल नीड थेरेपी, 84% पीपल नीड थेरेपी टू जस्टिफाई देयर एग्जिस्टेंस इन अ हाईली कंपेटिटिव एनवायरनमेंट, अ वेरी वेरी कंपेटिटिव एनवायरनमेंट। पीपल आर नॉट केपेबल टू जस्टिफाई देयर एग्जिस्टेंस। What is madness according to postmodernist thinkers? What is madness? Madness is the absence of work according to Michel Foucault. Who is mad? Madman is the one who is not able to justify his existence in a competitive environment. प्रॉब्लम ये है कि जो हमारे इंडिकेटर्स हैं, सोशल इंडिकेटर्स, जिनकी बुनियाद पर हम अपनी सोसाइटी की इंटेलेक्चुअल ग्रोथ और कल्चरल ग्रोथ और सोशल ग्रोथ को आइडेंटिफाई करते हैं, वो ये है कि हमारे पास कितने कन्फाइनमेंट सेंटर्स हैं, हमारे पास कितने स्कूल्स हैं, कितनी जेलें हैं, कितने हॉस्पिटल्स हैं। पोस्ट मॉडर्न थिंकर्स ये कहते हैं कि तुमने कैसी सोसाइटी कंस्ट्रक्ट की जिसमें इतने हॉस्पिटल्स हैं, क्यों है इतने हॉस्पिटल्स? आप ये कहते हैं कि इसलिए हॉस्पिटल्स हैं कि पहले के इंसान इंसान नहीं होते थे, 18 सेंचुरी से पहले इंसान थोड़ी होते थे, वो उनको थोड़ी पता था इलाज कैसे होता है। मॉडर्नाइजेशन ने बताया इलाज क्या होता है, और उसके नतीजे में जो सोसाइटी उन्होंने इमर्ज की उसको कहते हैं मेडिकलाइजेशन ऑफ सोसाइटी, पूरी की पूरी सोसाइटी, सोसाइटी ऑफ